What do we find now? Swimwear! Oh, goodness.
Scout ship setting.
That's what it looked like. Funny, that's not the one from the DLC either. The DLC, he had a dragon and everything. So this is what they meant by the black and white. Most of the outfits come with black and white.
The matter is the black and white.
Oh man, you wish you can swim in there. Oh, so
Eleanor, what's your game here?
The mother and daughter, you mean? That's on me. I'll search for them myself.
I don't care about that.
Well, what then?
Why are you actively helping us decipher the book when we're using it to thwart the Abbey's plans?
You think I might be deliberately misleading you? Laying a trap of some sort for you all?
Are you?
I think you're a lot of things, Demon, but foolish is not one of them. I want to know the truth. I want to know what Lord Artorias is trying to accomplish. And there's something happening in the world right now. I want to know what it is. Unfortunately, little old Eleanor has never been deemed trustworthy enough to be given such information. So, my only option is to find out for myself.
You've got the soul searching down at least.
The Abbey and your band of rogues follow two different paths, but something tells me either will lead me to the same destination.
And so you don't see any need to lie to us?
Exactly.
And what'll you do if those truths don't line up cleanly with what you believe?
I'm not sure yet.
As honest an answer as any. Either way, it looks like you'll be working with us for the near future.
Yes, for now.
Hey, could I ask you something?
What is it?
About the Therians. I've heard you call yourself a Therian before. Is there any particular insight you have about them?
No, none. Artorias said I was one, that's all.
And that doesn't bother you?
Does it bother you?
Nope, not at all. If you're not worried, then neither am I.
I'm surrounded by freaks. But was that truly the reason Ceres chose me?
Velvet keeps picking on Madame Eleanor! They're total opposites, so I know they're just gonna clash sometimes, but Velvet takes it too far!
You really think they're totally opposite?
If Madame Eleanor is a white lily, then Velvet is a black rose. If Madame Eleanor is a soaring Pegasus, then Velvet is a wolf in the shadows. If Madame Eleanor is a plate of spaghetti carbonara, Velvet is squid ink noodles with seaweed.
Perfect. I don't follow you completely, but I think I get the point.
I'm sure you understand. The two have nothing at all in common. And since they don't share anything in common, some fighting now and then just can't be helped.
Well, they both have beautiful hair.
Okay, but we're talking a noble exorcist and an aloof demon.
Eleanor sometimes treats you coldly. And Velvet has helped me more times than I can count.
Madame Eleanor gives herself fully to the salvation of others, but Velvet is bent solely on revenge.
That means they're both motivated by thoughts of others.
How is the cheerful and talkative Madame Eleanor at all the same as the brooding, taciturn Velvet?
Both of them talk to me when it's just the two of us together.
You're just trying to be contrary.
I'm only telling you what I've experienced.
Actually, I feel that Madame Eleanor isn't really reaching out to me.
It's all right if Eleanor doesn't want to talk to you. I'm here for you, Bienfu. You aren't alone.
That just makes me feel lonelier.
You two are opposites yourselves.
Huh?
Yeah, what? Big, you pervert. That's the other one he is.
I'll finish this now.
Fire!
You too.
Well, not bad. You too, dude. Mm. The bird.
Right then, let's finish this.
They were nothing.
Were they Yu-Gi-Oh? Oh no! Oh no! Is that Yu-Gi-Oh? Oh yes! Rita, you and Robin, they were stupid when
I said it. I said it to them. Oh no! Oh yes!
Oh yeah, stupid!
Who are they making that video? Stupid!
And I thought it was the best thing in the world. Mm-hmm. Oh no! Oh no!
Oh yes!
I was amazing, wasn't I?
Oh yeah, that's a shame.
Of course, revenge. Hey, Snake.
Everyone ready to play?
Run with me.
We're finished here. Let's go.
Severus Wave.
To the third stage, the third one. Switch that out. That's it. Mm-hmm.
Which way is that?
Deception.
Disgrace. Look, Big Pop over there. Whoa, look how big he is!
this is gonna be fun. Mom burgers can be.
You're strong, but I'm stronger.
Is this
dark and light? Break it!
Sky's like beguile!
Holy fire!
Illusory tail!
There's a speed on that sucker.
Blades of wind, slice them. No escape. Let's go. Eat it. Let's go. Air
flash. Now, rise. Arise. Ascending. Angel. Swirling black crack fire.
Sky's like beguile.
No mercy. Wounds that won't heal. Carving the flesh.
Sky's like beguile.
Not good.
Crushing weight. Gaze upon my fiery my head. Swirling black fire of no escape.
Air
thrust.
Die.
Healing.
Die.
Swirling black fire of no escape. Black is star. Fire. Don't get him, you three.
Windlash.
I'll help you.
I refuse to fall here.
A lot of people got their stuff upgraded.
Grab that bitch. We hit that hole.
Fabulous! Right, fabulous! Keep forgetting when I was on training now, he was always using the same tennis.
We're here and we've heard. We're here and we've heard.
I'm extra good at beating up the weak ones.
Was that supposed to be a joke?
Chesty, where are you? Fucking chest. They're fucking chest. Is it for this whole place or just this one here? And where is it? Is it underwater or something? Keep on looking that way. Like some other place you get over there that you see that little item over there.
Oh yeah. gotta say, this place is beautiful, though.
Yeah. I almost every place we went to, it looks so colorful. It looked like somebody actually got a good design, because on the other ones, some of them look bored. Oh my.
This rocky shore just keeps going. Just don't step on any sea slugs, okay?
Why not? What's the big deal?
It's just that it isn't pretty. Their insides squish everywhere.
Yikes. That sounds pretty traumatizing.
Then again, if you pickle their innards, it makes for a great snack.
You eat them?
Oh, don't be a baby. You've had worse.
Forget the sea slugs. Try not to step on the coral.
Good point. Coral is alive and needs our protection.
Or maybe it's because some of it can be sold for jewelry.
I didn't mean either of those reasons. Although Manann appears similar to Maclear Beach, it was formed by a completely different process.
Now that you mention it, this area is covered by rocks.
Maclear is just your average seashore. But Manann here was made by the slow corrosion of seaside caves.
They were worn away by the waves?
That too. But mainly, it was the handiwork of a rock-eating species of coral, known as ravening table coral. Stay in contact long enough, and they'll melt your flesh right off.
Ah, so that's why it tingles every time I touch the coral.
Why didn't you warn us earlier?
That sounds evil.
What?
Pretty good. Okay, sounds stupid on me.
New attack!
To the tunnel, there we go! For our reasons, we cannot say these words in the reason.
Not worth my time.
Oh, my star! You're that big! You
don't
think about the star! I want to play! Blue! Dark and light!
Quick, then!
Geostigma! Geostigma! Black away the shadow of darkness!
How's
that? Blue!
Black the
star!
Illusory veil!
Holy fire!
Perform
most victory!
Who else who does those scrolls? Oh yeah, we're Sailor Moon.
Luffy said, have you been taking care of that rhino stag roast like a good boy?
Of course. I make sure to feed it every night before I go to sleep, since it's nocturnal.
How long are you going to keep on calling it a rhino stag roast?
I don't know. It's a new kind of beetle, so it's gonna be hard to tell if it's really a rhino or a stag. You're asking a lot of questions. Bienfu, do you like bugs?
Duh! I love rhinoceros and stag beetles both! What guy doesn't find them fascinating?
Right? So which kind of beetle do you think it is? Rhino or stag?
Oh, that's a tough question. But guess what? Miss Mogulu taught me a surefire way to tell.
I didn't know there was a way to tell.
Yeah, but if I do it, you gotta name it after me, all right? Come on! What guy doesn't wish he had a cool bug named after himself, right? And besides, Miss Mogulu told me that this technique is so good that it's only fair to have a bug named after you in return. So what do you say, man to man? Come on, let's live the dream!
Oh, all right. How can I say no to that? Besides, we all did work together to capture it anyway.
Yay! Thanks, Laffy-Sack. All right, show me the bug, and I'll tell you what it is. Miss Mogulu says you need to open up its outer wings and get a good whiff of the thin underwings.
I'm pretty sure I remember rhinoceros and stag beetles smelling really nasty under their wings.
Is it really that bad?
Why not find out for yourself?
No thanks. I think I'll pass.
Maybe you shouldn't do this after all, Bienfu.
You probably just want to hog the name all to yourself! Well, too bad! A real man never goes back on his word! If it packs a mean punch, then it's a rhinoceros beetle. And if it smells really zesty, then it's a stag beetle.
I don't know about this.
Just let him do it, Lafayette. He's already volunteered.
I can do this! Just you watch! This smell is the most bad thing that ever bad-batted it!
Whoa! He fainted with his eyes still open! Hey, wake up! Wake up, Bienfu!
Miss Mogulu, as soon as I smelled it, my nose literally exploded.
He looks like he's having a bad dream.
I spy with my little eyes a kiddo who's spying at my bewitching waist.
Oh, sorry. I just couldn't help it. What are those books, anyway?
Oh, that's a great question. Since you asked, I'll reveal the secrets of my tomes just for you. On the right, I've got my household ledger in the back, and my magic encyclopedia in the front. That one I mostly use for oil blotting paper.
What's oil blotting paper?
It's a girl thing. The two on the left are my heavy book, which I use for flower pressings, and then my super pop-up book.
A super pop-up book?
When you open it, it pops out with the force of a raging river! When an enemy has me cornered, I can just open it up facing a nearby wall and pop! Instant getaway! The only downside is that it's a real pain to try to get closed again, so I haven't used it in years.
What about the book right in front?
That's actually layer cake.
Whoa, really?
Seared into its batter are precious bits of knowledge. Eating it is just as good for your brain as it is for your stomach.
Wow! I had no idea that was possible!
He's taking this so seriously, I almost feel bad.
All of your books are so interesting, Mogulu! That's really cool!
There's no end to your curiosity, is there? What do you say? Want to take a closer look?
Boy, would I!
If you really do, then say, Mogulu, I want to get to know you better.
Mogulu, I want to get to know you better.
All right, I accept. I'll reveal to you my most private secrets.
Wow, so that's what's on the other side of these books. I wouldn't have ever guessed that.
What the? What are you doing with Lafayette? He said he wanted to see, so I'm showing him. You have no right to stand in the way of his desires.
It's my job to protect him as his vessel, especially from someone so wicked as yourself. Also, what you're doing runs contrary to public decency.
Witches aren't supposed to be decent.
These bindings with the locks on them. This style used to be really popular during the Meliodas dynasty.
Now that I know you're such a bad influence for him, I'll be keeping a closer eye on you.
If you can't learn to take it easy, nobody's ever gonna want to marry you, you know.
Like you're a shining example of marriage material yourself.
Hey, Mogulu, could you turn them over one more time? I want to see how the book's attached to your belt.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, Mogulu, I was wondering about that book you have on your waist. The one you called your heavy book, for flower pressings.
Your curiosity truly knows no bounds, does it, kiddo? Okay, nobody else knows this, but since you're so interested, I'd hate to leave you hanging. My heavy book, the one I use for flower pressings, is none other than a collection of Bienfu's poetry.
Bienfu likes to write poems?
Yep. You'd never guess it, but he's actually just about the best Malak poet around. Some people even call him the Great Norman Poet. Here, I'll read you my favorite one. If there is something unimportant happening to the east, I'm made to go there and back. If there is something unimportant happening to the west, I'm made to go there and back. I can never rest nor be at peace. Every day my life is a living hell.
That's heavy stuff.
Isn't it? That's what makes it so good for pressing flowers. It's so wonderfully, oppressively heavy.
Moggy Lou, your face has gone all sinister looking.
Oh, goodness.
I really love her dope voice.
Scout ship.
The more scouting you do, the more you get everybody's outfits, and I heard they're all black and white. They have them.
Wow. Don't matter if you're black or white.
Excuse me there, fat bird. Oh, I got powers combined. I am Captain Planet. Captain Planet, he's a hero. Gonna drop your balls down to zero.
You're fighting the Reaper.
We won, right? Right?
Yep, sure did. Perfect XP for this place, too. Charging up the room, that's pretty good.
Tentacle.
I mean,
damn it.
Tentacle.
Say sure
to
fight
you. You're the one who said it. I didn't
do
anything.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you need to calm down. I'll beat your butt.
I'm calm.
Nope, you're not.
I'm not yelling or anything.
No. Hello. Ooh,
I'll finish this quick.
Of course, this danger is going to turn around.
Well, that about does it.
You know, boy dancer, please. Please. Strata.
Two chests. Baby bee bird.
Captain Planet. He's a hero. Gonna kick your balls down to zero.
Yeah, you kinda messed up the song for me, Shuri. When? What the hot girl planet?
With your power combined, I am Captain Planet!
I always thought that guy from Reading the Rainbow would have been the perfect Captain Planet. He looks just like him.
I thought so too.
I'll
finish this now.
It's over, right?
Yeah, too fast, Eddie is.
We can do this.
Let's go.
Wow, all sorts of things popped out. Yep.
Cause she's cute for purple puffs.
We banned you. Disgrace.
But I was like, was he really scarred?
Picking up on anything?
Yeah.
She just probably
in the direction of the temple. The feeling's getting stronger now.
Oh yeah, I shook when it was a monster looking at me, so I don't know if that was feeling the same.
Don't waste my time.
Damn boots that we don't need. Little sneaky, pass right over you. Woohoo!
Everything's a soul.
Beautiful.